Och så blir det alltså Underworld live och också intervju med Rage Against the Machine. Missa nu inte detta. Hej!
Machine rages on, or Rage Against the Machine. That band is anti-family and it's pro-terrorists.
All of which are American dreams! All of which are American dreams!
Every band talks about their opinions and their songs. And sometimes, you know, bands might just be not concerned with nothing more than Nookie, you know, and the only responsibility you have as an artist is to be true in your art. And if what you care about are, you know, sort of political issues, then you would be lying not to be singing about it.
If you're not turned on to politics, politics will turn on you.
You know, in a lot of our fans, there's a you know, an awareness, and I think our fans are smart. And I think that you know, that even the fans that just come to the band because of the music or because of the aggression of it, you know, often they get more than they bargained for, and that the lyrical content is very different than a lot of bands that play hard music.
But do you think you have a lot of fans that don't really care about your lyrics?
Well, I think that a lot. Yeah, I mean, 'cause we don't. It's music that, you know, it's good rock and roll music, you know, it's not like a coffee house folk music for intellectuals, you know, it's music that makes a crowd of 100,000 jump up and down. So people are drawn to it because of maybe some of the more rock elements. But like I said, you know, a lot of those people come for one reason, they leave with something very... I think because Rage Against the Machine is one of the only overtly political bands that, you know, manages to probably be on your TV show, would be my guess, is that we're often asked that question. Never do, or very rarely do reporters ask, you know, escapist bands, bands that sing about cars and girls, like, well, why aren't you singing about politics? You know, like, I think that, you know, love and relationships and whatever are a very important part of the human experience and, you know, should be sung about in songs. But also things like, you know, solidarity and resistance to, you know, injustice are a very important part of human experience. And we sing about those things. It's no less legitimate than the other part. But many bands deal with, you know, sort of the romance, and very few bands deal with political issues.
So there won't be, like, any love song from the Rage Against the Machine?
I think every one of our songs is a love song.
Your albums on a big commercial Sony Epic label. Does it bother you that a lot of people criticize you because you're on this big commercial label?
Yeah, well, I think it's completely unfine. It's not well thought out, because if you've professed as a band to be like an indie rock band, and that you don't want to have anything to do, you know, you want to make 45s, sell them out of the back of a pickup truck, you know, and play nothing but squats, that's one thing. Rage Against the Machine's never been that band. We're an activist band, not an indie band. It's very different. We're interested in political change, and how you affect that is by moving many people. Okay, there's just two completely separate things. For example, you know, political prisoners like Leonard Peltier or Mumia Bujumal in the United States, they don't care what record label we're on. They want to get out of jail. So you strategize to find out how to do that. And how you do that is by reaching a lot of people with a
message.
And
you do by performing.
Yeah, absolutely.
Ett tydligt bevis på att Rage Against the Machine är mycket mer än bara politisk propaganda är fansens enorma musikaliska engagemang. Det blir nästan rent av humor när man på bandets hemsida läser fansens livliga diskussioner om vilka effektpedaler Tom Morello använder.
Great. I mean, I was interested in that when I was a fan of The Clash. You know, part of what made me want to play guitar was that Joe Strummer, who was in this big band, The Clash, had exactly the same small little crappy amplifier that I did. I was very interested in his amplifier. So I totally understand and accept that. And I think that's an important part of it, that we play music that moves, you know, people and that is aggressive. And that's the kind of music that I grew up on, that we love too.
You did name Joe Strummer as an influence. Do you have any other guitar?
Oh yeah, definitely. I mean, like, there was some more traditional guitar hero, you know, like Jimmy Page, and Randy Rhodes was always a favorite. Even Yngwie Malmsteen was. I bought that first record, and it was one of the things that encouraged me. It helped me to be a dedicated musician.
Never seen you without a cap.
There you go. Enjoy.
Det har länge ryktats om en liveplatta med Rage Against the Machine, och vad som händer med den nu när Zack hoppat av är än så länge oklart. Men klart är i alla fall att de kommer släppa en coverplatta, givetvis lagom till julruschen. En coverplatta med låtar av bland andra Bob Dylan, Rolling Stones, Devo, MC5 och Eric B. and Rakim. Rage Against the Machine har ju på många sätt gjort sig kända som rockens stora politiska agitatorer och alltid protesterat mot saker som social och politisk orättvisa, maktcentrering och storbolagens ökande inflytande. Texterna och inte minst videorna talar sitt tydliga språk. Ett svenskt band som också verkar ta lite ställning.